I'm Meghan Patrick, and this is my Opry debut.
It's like heavy and light at the same time. I don't even know how to explain it. I'm just honestly, I'm like kind of trying to just process all the emotions I have right now, and I'm trying to just like soak it in and like remember this moment, because days like this, things like this go by so fast. So I'm just trying to like remember everything right now and not cry.
There's just no way I could ever imagine my life not doing this. Nothing has ever really come quickly or easily for me in my career, but being here right now, it's all worth it, and it's so much sweeter knowing that I fought for it and I clawed my way here.
This is me right here in the middle. How you doing?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Nice to meet you.
I basically learned I could sing when I was like 12 years old. I started taking singing lessons. I auditioned for the school musical and I found a passion there, and I really enjoyed it. But I also at the time was a competitive snowboarder, and that was kind of the big dream at the time. I wanted to go to the Olympics. And then fast forward to my senior year of high school, and I had a really bad fall. I broke my back, dislocated my shoulder, snapped my collarbone, broke my ribs, severe concussion. I was truly lucky to walk after that accident. I mean, it ended my career, basically. But what I didn't realize is that it was God saying, hey, I got something better for you over here. And I really turned to music while I was healing from that injury. And so when I got on the other side of that recovery, I had a new dream. I actually started playing in this bluegrass band, which I always say was my gateway drug to country music, aside from hearing it, you know, on the radio. And finally, for the first time, I was like, I always knew it was music, but now I knew exactly what it was, and it was country music. So the last couple years were extremely difficult. I came out of my Canadian record deal, like I lost my first team that I ever worked with. I made some bad choices in some of the people that I worked with, and I really paid for it emotionally and otherwise. And I felt like I was just like treading water and barely keeping my head above. Nobody understood me, nobody was listening to me. And it was really frustrating, but I can see why I needed to struggle and feel that frustration, because it really pushed me to stop worrying about what everyone else thought about me. And so it was kind of about unapologetically doing things the way that I wanted to do it. I've been doing this for a long time. Like I said, 22 years. I didn't just step off the bus yesterday. So anytime I've started to feel myself getting anxious or stressing out or getting down on myself or doubting, I'm like, nope, that's not MFP energy. We're not doing that anymore.
She's a fireball, and that's what I love about her. And she's, I don't know, just so incredible. And she inspires me every day, and this is just so awesome to be here on her first time at the Opry.
I'm manifesting all the dreams, all the things, and I'm just going for it. So I was shooting a music video, and Ford, my director, he was like, all right, you come up, sit over here, and they've got the lights and everything set up, and we're about to start shooting, I think. And then Ford goes, oh, that's weird. Why is Terry Clark FaceTiming me?
What's up?
So I had a question for you, real quick. I know you're working, but what are you doing on April 11th?
I don't know, Randy, what am I doing on April 11th? And Terry goes, she's like, well, I know what you're doing.
You're playing the Grand Ole Opry.
Just waterworks. But it was really special having it be Terry, because Terry has been just a mentor and a great friend to me, and she's inspired me. She's been there for me a lot, given me a lot of advice, and I look up to her.
We're gonna make history together right now. Put your hands together for Meghan Patrick.
Definitely moving to Nashville was a huge turning point for me. I was a new kid in town. I was also the Canadian new kid in town, which I discovered had kind of a weird stigma around it. But you know what? It's the best decision I ever made. And I was really lucky to meet some of my absolute best friends as soon as I came here. Literally the first night I came into town, I met Lainey Wilson and Casey Tindall, and they became like sisters to me right away. And that very much felt like God was saying, hey, I'm gonna give you everything you need here. And whenever I get to a moment like this where I'm living a dream I've prayed for, I can see why it all had to happen the way it did. We can move to LA, make $1 million, maybe even someday we can win an Oscar. I can say I saw it first, the greatest show on earth.
This is what she's dreamed of her whole life, is to be you know, on stage at the Grand Ole Opry. So to see that come, you know, full fruition, you know, everything happening for her, like just to see the joy in her eyes and just the inspiration coming back out of her, it's there's nothing better.
Thank you so much for making this the best night of my life. I love you guys.
As you listen all over the world to a standing ovation in the Opry House tonight, Meghan Patrick.